Just let me know when it starts.
Ayan, it started.
Okay. So, good evening, everyone. Welcome to the second session of Luminous, our management consulting workshop. So, in the second session, we'll be dealing about case studies. The first session was taken by Sudarshan regarding guesstimates. And so this is the agenda of the session. And one thing I would like to tell that there is some disturbance going on near my house. So in case there is any like noise or you are not able to hear me properly, just you can type in the chat box and Akshay and Harshit would be just telling me to repeat that particular part again. So this is the agenda. First is the bridging the gap between the first session and the second one, an introduction to the world of consulting. Then why case studies are important and what are various business problems which the industry leaders face in their daily life. Then approach towards a case study. Then do's and don'ts of case studies. Then we'll be discussing a little bit about our frameworks. And the most important part will be a mock case interview, followed by which for the students who are interested to pursue this further, I have provided some further reading material which they can easily get it on net. And once the presentation from my end is over, there will be a doubt session where you are free to unmute yourself or you can just put it in the chat box. The like either me or Harshit or Akshay would try to address all the queries. So first, what is guesstimates? It was already covered in the first session that it is basically guess estimates. So why did we study guesstimates and why was this part of our session? Because if you look at real world problems, the real world business problems, which we'll be discussing further, concrete data is not available and there is no step-by-step procedure to solve it. There are so many things for which data is unknown, and based on the constraints which we have and the inputs which we get, we need to come to an approximate answer to it. That's why the guesstimate skills are very important in the world of consulting. Then what is management consulting? As the term goes, consulting is basically giving advice, and management consulting means giving advice to the top management of any organizations. So there will be management consulting firms who will have expertise in particular domain, and if any industry leaders or the organization have a problem with respect to those domain, they will go to these management consulting firms and then they will help in setting their problems right. Then the top firms in management consulting and the prerequisites for case studies. So this is a list of top management consulting firms. And coming to the prerequisites for case studies, the foremost thing is having good communication skills and analytical abilities. Because mind you that once you are into the world of consulting, you'll be dealing with the upper management of any organization, and hence your behavior needs to be strictly professional and the communication should be up to the mark. And not only good communication, you should have very good analytical abilities as well, because you will have tons of data and you should know what you should be doing with it. So you should have quick maths, because this quick maths is for case studies. You will be realizing it soon enough that why we need it. Then we should have knowledge on technical terms of industries, because when you go to when you see case study problems, the information available is very, very less, and based on the questions you ask to the interviewer, you will get the data accordingly. So with respect to a particular industry, you should know that what are the questions which we should ask. So suppose if there are manufacturing industry or service-based industry, hotel industry, then airline industry, you should know that if there is a problem in that industry, what type of question should be asked. And we should have a general knowledge on economics and finance, because it will help us in, first of all, formulating our answers properly and to get further insights regarding the case which we are solving. And depending on the company, we may also be needing skills of Python, R and SQL, Power BI or any other business intelligence tool, then Tableau, then Microsoft Office. In Microsoft Office particularly, I'm talking about Word, Excel and PPT. and machine learning and artificial intelligence may also be needed, but based on the company and the expertise of the company and the role for which you are applying, accordingly these skills, like among this list, what are the ones which they'll be requiring will be shown, and accordingly we can do our preparation. Then why we solve case studies and various business problems. So any typical organization, it is divided basically into, the management is divided into three parts. One is the strategy, planning and operation. So strategy is basically for the long term planning. It is the vision of the company, which can be a 10-year plan or a 20-year plan, where they will decide the, like, how they have to do the business, and the entire roadmap of the organization is decided. Then next comes planning, which is relatively a short term phase. It can be for 1 year or 2 years or 5 years. And the last comes operation, which can be on daily basis or monthly basis. And even if company does micromanagement, it can also be on hourly basis. So the various problems are faced in all these functions, the strategy, planning and operations. And accordingly, once we practice our case studies, we'll be knowing, once we are experienced with this, we'll be knowing how we can tackle real world problems. And the case study, you can say it is like a mock simulation of what you'll be doing in consulting, because by the way you are doing a case interview, as I told the prerequisite, the interviewer can judge your communication skills and analytical skills and how you approach towards real life problems. Then next are, what are the various business problems which the organizations face in real life. So the first one and the most important one can be profitability, that is profit and loss. So the typical questions in the case interviews of profitability can be, a mobile manufacturing company is facing 10% loss since the past 3 years. You as a consultant, how can you try to increase the profits? So if I'm talking about loss, it is a clear cut indication that, yeah, okay, it's a problem. But sometimes even profits can also be a problem, because suppose you make a strategic decision that if you implement this particular model of business, you can expect 20% or 30% of your profits. Your profits will increase by 20 or 30% year on year growth. But suppose you are getting only 10% or 15%, then although your company is being profitable, but that was not as per the planned strategy. So that's why even profit also can be part of a problem. Later in the mock case interview, we'll be seeing exactly what this means. Then the other problems can be market entry, where suppose you have your capital and you want to enter into a new industry. So you should see the geographical location and what are the various constraints which you are facing in order to enter the market. The next problem comes expansion. The expansion can be in terms of our products, services, or business. The best examples for expansion can be Reliance or Amazon, where initially they started with one particular line of business, but right now they have ventured into so many segments. Then the last problem can be merger and acquisition. So merger basically means a strategic alliance between two entities or organizations for a common goal. It can be either to increase their profits or to increase their market share or to dominate the market. And acquisition is nothing but one company acquiring a particular segment or an entire business of an organization in order to either strengthen its capabilities or to expand the business. Then this is the common approach to a case study. So case studies, it can be like of two types. One can be where your interview itself starts with a case study, or it can be a general interview where the interviewer will be asking your basic details about your resumes or projects. And once they want to test your analytical abilities, they can give you a small case studies or guesstimates. For example, what are the number of white shirts which can you predict the number of white shirts in Bangalore in the year 2021? Or can you tell the number of bicycles in India? So based on this, like the case study can also start in the middle. So assuming it's the first case, so first you should greet the interviewer. And the next important part is understand the scope of the question. That is your problem statement. Because there are various types of case studies. Few can be where the entire data would be given to you and it would be like a 5 pages or 10 pages case study, where based on the given data, you need to answer a specific set of questions. So companies like ZS Associates or BlackBuck may follow that model. Then there are few case studies where you just have 2 to 3 lines of problem statement and there is literally zero data available. So based on what questions you are asking, you will get the required data and accordingly you need to solve the problem. So when the problem scope, when the problem statement is very limited, it's very important that you understand each and every word of that problem statement. Then ask the relevant questions to get the quantitative data. Let me tell you one thing, in a case interview, the interviewer would be knowing the exact answer and he or she will have the entire data. But when the problem statement is presented to you, it is just 2 or 3 lines. So you should know what kind of questions you should ask to get that required data. Then once you have the required data, you need to explain the approach to the interviewer, that what will be your overall plan, how you want to solve this particular case. And once they are satisfied with it, then you need to do proper segmentation. And segmentation is done to identify the root cause of the problem. So later in the mock case interview, we'll be seeing how segmentation is done. And when you are segmenting, like it's not a rule that, I mean, the questions which you asked in the start, those are enough. In case when you're doing segmentation, you need further data, you can, or you're stuck, like you're not able to go in a particular direction, then you can ask questions again to your interviewer in order to like further deep dive into the branch, the segment. Then come up with an approximate answer. Here, the interviewer is not expecting that you come up with, like I'm talking about the case interviews. In the real world, obviously you need to come up with the precise answers, but in the case interview, the most important thing which they're looking is your approach, but not the exact numerical accuracy. Then once you come up with the answer, you need to give conclusions of whatever you did. And in case a recommendation is asked, you need to give that as well. Now, suppose if a question is asked that where you conclude that what were the faults in that scenario, then you may even be asked that, okay, you as a consultant, what recommendation you can provide in order to tackle that problem. So this is the general approach. Then do's and don'ts of a case study. So do's is ask relevant questions. I'm stressing on this again and again because right now you might be thinking that why is he saying this thing again and again? But when you yourself are practicing case studies, you will realize what is the importance of asking questions. So ask important questions, and don'ts is don't ask questions like a by-hearted list. So like later we'll be discussing about frameworks, but once you are habituated with the frameworks, it's not like you will just keep on asking all the questions at once. So an experienced interviewer can tell within seconds that you have just by-hearted a framework and you are asking all the questions in an order. So it should not be like that. You should identify that based on that particular business problem, what kind of questions must be asked in order to get the data. Then second do's is understand the scope and technical words properly before beginning the case. Because like later you'll be seeing in the example, where few words, although the meaning may sound quite simple, the actual context might be different. So you should clarify first that what that particular term means. And the second don't is, don't write the solution in a haphazard manner. Because this, whatever case study you are doing, it is not for yourself, but later you have to tell it to some third person. So he or she should understand that what was your exact thinking approach, because you won't be available 24/7 to explain that, okay, I did this step and I approached in this manner to get that particular result. Your presentation should be such that even a third person who doesn't know anything can understand what was your thinking process. Then You should round off numbers for easy calculation. Not only for case studies, even in guesstimates, when you are doing, you need to do quick maths, and you, like, you may or may not have a calculator. So at that time, like, you can't be multiplying a 5-digit number with another 3-digit number. So the best approach would be to round off the numbers. So never try to use the exact numbers for calculation, because again, I'm repeating, the interviewer is looking for your approach and thinking process. Then the most important thing is practice mock case interviews with your friends. So even I personally did that, and it actually helped me a lot, and it makes you feel more confident once you have practiced more cases. Now, it's not a rule that after practicing cases, now you can solve any case which you get, but at least you will have some confidence that, okay, I may be able to go in a particular direction, or I may be able to solve the case partially. Now, generally what people do is, they, like, there are many resources available or mock case interviews. So they may just read that and they'll feel that, okay, I can do a case interview. So there may be one odd people who can actually do that by just reading and understanding the cases. And when a real life case study is asked, then they can implement, they can solve it with ease, but that's not the general case. So never try to read and understand the cases. Practice, like, first understand the ideology behind cases, then try to understand various industries and try to understand the frameworks. After that, practice the mock case interviews with your friends. So next comes the most important thing, that is frameworks. So frameworks, in a layman term, I can say it as a template or a general procedure to solve a particular, framework is a general term, it's not for case studies. So like a general standard operating procedure can be called a framework. So this is the profitability framework. If you notice that if there is, the profits are increasing or decreasing, the segmentation is done based on revenue and cost. So either, just look at it step by step. So profit high or low. Suppose if it is low, then you're dividing into revenue and cost. So are the revenues high or low, or are the cost or high or low? So suppose if I say that, okay, cost is exactly the same, so you can remove this branch. Then you have to go to revenue. Then revenue, is it high or low? So if it is low, then again, you go to the next segment. Is it price? Is the issue with price, or is it issue with the number of units sold? Then again, if I say that the unit sold is constant, then you will go to price. So from the increase or decrease in profit, the final reason for the increment or decrement was the price per unit. So all this data, or you'll arrive at this conclusion only after asking proper questions. So the example which I have given, which I'll be giving later, you will realize that how depth the analysis can go in a real case interview. Then this is for various other business segment, sorry, business problems. If you're looking for market entry or your expansion of business, for those, and merger and acquisitions. So these are various types of frameworks. So suppose you will take a hypothesis and you will divide it into various segments. First you want to know about the customers. So you can ask various questions, like, who is the customers? Then what does each customer segment want? Then distribution channel. So in this, in this question also, there'll be various sub questions. Like, suppose if in the profitability framework, you saw that how a particular branch is divided into sub branches. So in the customers also, customer division can be done based on their age, or it can be done based on the geographical location. Then the gender split, the male and female. Suppose if the case study is regarding some beauty products, you want to enter into the market. So you need to see that in the target audience, the percentage of male and female. So such kind of analysis you need to do based on the type of the industry which you are looking at. Then next comes products. In that, you can ask various questions like nature of product, commodity or differentiable good. Then are there any substitutes available? Then the life cycle of product. And here, this is the one thing which I'm not encouraging. That is, like, if you take product, it's not that you have to ask this 5 or 6 questions for sure. Based on the particular case study, with one or two questions, if you are getting the relevant data, then just finish this branch and go to the next one. And later, in case again you are stuck up, then you need to analyze that, okay, was there any particular information about the product which I didn't ask? And you can ask that again and you can proceed further. And the third branch is company, where you see the capabilities and expertise, then distribution channels, cost structures, then the investment cost and the organizational structure. And the last one, it is very important, the competitive analysis. It can be used for competitive benchmarking or for merger and acquisitions, because you need to see how in a particular industries, in a particular industry, how are your competitors performing with respect to you. So in case you are lagging in a particular business segment, you can see that, okay, why is that particular competitor a leader in this segment? And accordingly, you can try to change your strategies. Just 1 minute, guys. And this is another framework where suppose you want to launch a new product. So you need to, if you notice, these frameworks are basically the type of questions which you need to answer in order to make a final decision regarding the case. So if a new product is there, the product, what are its specialties? Is it patented? Are the substitute available? Then the pricing. Then other branches, if you see, customers, then company and finance and industry. So just I'll pause for 10 seconds like that. You can see that, I mean, in what angle you need to see in order to make judgments. So just I'll be pausing for 5 to 10 seconds. Here also, if you notice in the pricing, that you have to do either price-based value to the customer, then competitive analysis and cost-based. So how much profit are you aiming for? Profit percentage are you aiming for from your product? Or so if you want to enter a new market and already there is some leader, so in order to make your customers prefer your product, you need to reduce the price and have the same quality or better quality when compared to your competitors. So such things needs to be analyzed. Then, so this is my after I solved many case studies, this is something which I realized and I would like you also to follow the same. This is my personal opinion. Once you keep on doing, maybe you may have a different approach. So I say that instead of having a proper framework, try to make it like a checklist where based on the question, you should analyze that what are the things which you need to ask. So you can ask the info about the company or the industry, then who are the customers, then the past data. Suppose if I just say that our mobile manufacturing company is facing 10% loss, you as a consultant, what will you do? So here you need to get some past data also, because surely the interviewer would be having, because when there is loss, that is surely loss with respect to the previous years. So you need to ask questions that can you, for how long have we been facing loss? So such kind of things. Then market in which it operates. The market as in I'm talking about the geographical location, then among which customer age groups are we operating? Such kind of things. You should have these subheadings in your mind, and based on the case, case question which you get, the problem statement, as and when you want to get more insights, you should ask from the specific questions rather than following a proper frame. If you see this framework, it should not be okay, customers first, 5 questions I'll ask, then I'll go to product, I'll ask 5 questions, then I'll jump to company. Because as I told, the case interviewers will be very experienced and they will identify that if you are by-hearting frameworks or you are naturally asking those questions. Then you can ask questions about value chain. So value chain is nothing but the supply chain where if you take any product, we as a customers are receiving the final product, but for the manufacturing of that product and the way through which it went through your retail store is a supply chain. There are many entities involved. It can be the manufacturer, then raw material supplier, then wholesaler, retailers, and then comes customers. And between these also, there'll be various entities such as the warehouses, then transportation. So based on the question, you should also see that is there a, is a particular part of the value chain being affected due to which there is any issue, or like the entire, so value chain, everything, it is fine and we need to go into other aspects. So you should make the sub branches, and once you realize that, okay, there is no specific change in this segment, you need to jump to the next one. And then comes products and competitors. So this is the most important part of today's session, where we'll be doing a mock case interview. So I'll just tell you the sign convention before we start the case interview. The questions which are the normal font, that is by the candidate, the who is interviewing, and the fonts which are italicized, they are by the interviewer, and the fonts which are in bold, those are by the authors of the book Case Interview Cracked, and where they give analysis of whatever the conversation going on between the candidate and the interviewer. So this is the question. You are the CEO of a luxurious hotel resort chain in Thailand. The CEO is worried because the tourist growth rate in Thailand was at 6%, but revenue only grew by 4%. He wants you to find out what the problem is. So if you notice that, like I told you, that even profit percentage can also be a problem. Here, 6% is the tourist growth rate, but the revenue is only increasing by 4%. So let us start the case study. And before we start, I'll again go back to the slide where we see the approach of the case study. So understand the scope of the question, ask the relevant questions, explain the approach to the interviewer, do proper segmentation, ask questions in case you got stuck, come up with an approximate answer, give your conclusion and recommendation. Yeah. So here we ask the preliminary questions. The candidate asks, so the client expected a revenue growth of 6% in line with the tourist growth rate and wants us to figure out why not this is the case. So it is very important to know, because like when the tourist growth rate increased by 6%, like what did the CEO expect? That it should increase by 6% or more than 6%. So it is very important to clarify what is the scope of our problem. So here the CEO is expecting that if this is 6%, even the revenue should increase by 6%. Now, I wanted to ask a few clarifying questions. How many hotels are part of the chain? Are they evenly spread out in Thailand? If you go back to the question, here there is a typical case interview question where you have very, very limited data provided. But later, I'm just showing the solution. See, there are so much in-depth analysis is required. So from just a 3-4 lines to such a big analysis, what is the roadmap is what case interview is all about. So now we are trying to identify the exact business model and how the industry operates. So how many hotels are part of the chain? Are they evenly spread out in Thailand? So yeah, there are 20 hotels and evenly spread out across major tourist destination. So this shows that any particular hotel is not unique. The conditions for all the hotels are same. Then, would tourist growth rate mean year-on-year growth in total number of tourists in Thailand? Yes. So this was the thing which I was talking about. Understand each and every technical word. Here, if you see, it could also have meant the average number of tourists per night, which has a completely different meaning. Now, suppose if it is told that there are 10 manufacturing, you can say 1 lakh tourists per day, and that is the next day they are increasing by 4%, or is it the year-on-year growth? So we should first clarify what exactly the growth rate means. So there are certain industry standards to report figures. So as and when you get practice in case studies and you read more industrial articles, you will understand that what are the standard ways. Then you said we are luxurious hotel chain. Are there any other segments in the industry? What has their revenue growth rate been like? So this is again very important segmentation, because as I was giving the, let us take example of Reliance. Now if I'm saying that the telecommunication, if the problem statement is Reliance has been facing losses of 10% since the past 2 years. So you should know that entire Reliance has been facing losses, or because of one or few particular segments of Reliance, the entire company value is decreasing. So that's why the question has been asked that are there any other segments in the industry and what is their revenue growth rate? So for our purpose, there are economy and luxurious segments, and both have seen revenue growth rates of 4%. So I'll go back to the framework here. As and when you divide branches, if one particular thing is clear, so you can directly cut out that and go to the next branch and try to dig further. Yeah. So the entire hotel chain, it's divided into economy and luxurious, and both are growing at the same rate. So again, you can merge since both of them are alike. So there is an industry-wide trend across all segments. Now, one more important thing is we should always see whether the particular company is facing an issue or is it the entire industry. Now suppose, let me take example of an alcohol manufacturing company. Suppose in India, if there are particular states where lots of tax has been imposed, and you are operating in those regions, obviously you will have losses because of the heavy taxes. But your competitors, they are operating in the regions where they have the same customers as you, but the taxes are very less. So they'll be more profitable. So this particular problem is specific to your company. It's not related to the industry. If entire India has the same tax for alcohol, then this will be an industry-wide problem. So that's why here the point has been established that there is the industry-wide issue for there's an industry-wide issue and not specific to this particular hotel chain. Then since when have we been experiencing this problem? Again, this is also a very important thing, because let us come to the present, that is 2021. So if there is a manufacturing industry which has been facing loss just since 1 year, so we can say that, okay, COVID can be one major cause. So again, we need to further analyze whether if that's the issue or not. So we need to analyze that what is, since how long the problem we have been facing. Just read this point again. It's important to know whether a problem is company specific or industry wide trend. This helps to streamline the problem isolation process to a greater degree. By problem isolation, problem isolation means when we were dividing into segments, we are analyzing that, okay, there is some issue with this segment and we are further going deep into it. So that is problem isolation. So if all hotels in Thailand are experiencing a revenue decline, the cause is more likely to be decline in the tourist traffic in Thailand, an industry-wide problem, rather than poor service in your client's hotel, which is a company-specific issue. So now you can relate with what I meant with the alcohol example. The next comes the overall strategy. In the approach, I told you, right, that you need to tell the overall way through which you'll be solving the case study. So the candidate says, I'd like to see where the problem in revenue growth lies so that it is not par with the tourist growth rate. Then we can figure out how to solve this. Then again, we are analyzing that. Is it are all the 20 for the conditions for all the hotel, is it same or not? So are all the 20 hotels showing revenue growth rate of 4%? Yes, all are showing 4% growth figure. And you can assume there is no difference in the hotels or the tourist environment around them. So this is just a reassurance to say that the conditions for all the 20 hotels are similar. Now, suppose if the question would have been no, the revenue growth rate for all the 20 hotels are not similar. If this was the answer, then you should further ask questions. Okay, hello? Did someone say?
Yes,
Akshay? Should I continue?
Yes, now you can continue.
Guys, there is some disturbance. Maybe you can just So suppose if the question was, are all 20 hotels showing revenue growth of 4%? If the answer was no, then we need to further analyze, okay, how, what is the difference between that particular hotel and the remaining? Is it the geographical location or like suppose the customer service in those particular hotels is not good? We need to figure out based on what the data is given by the interviewer. What are our revenue streams and what is the revenue split in each and growth rate of each? So this is now you are seeing like how we are trying to get more and more data from just 3 to 4 line problem statement. So the revenue comes 80% from room rentals and 20% from VAS. VAS is nothing but value added services. Both segments have been have seen revenue growth of 4%. So okay, again now the conditions are becoming much more easier that the revenue growth rate for both the from two segments we are getting revenues and the growth rate has been same. Now suppose if the to make the question more complicated, we could have said that okay, only one particular segment there is a decline in the revenue, other has been increasing. Then you need to analyze both of them separately and the question could have become more complicated. Then the candidate says, I'd like to proceed by investigating the mismatch between tourist growth rate and revenue growth rate, starting with room rentals, since it makes 80% of the revenue. We'll get back to VAS later. So this is a management principle of Pareto's rule of 80-20. So it is basically like, it can be applied in any general cases, like 80% of wealth is with 20% of people and 20% of wealth is with 80% of people. Or like 80% of our exam preparation is done in 20% of time, or and 20% of our exam preparation is done in 80% of time. So there are various such management principles, and as and when you get more experienced, you'll be learning them. There are even Potter 5 forces of analysis. So there are various such terms. Then here, since like 80% of revenues is with room rental and that is most important, we would like to focus on that. Then take a moment to think what will be the most logical way to break down room rentals given the original question of the interviewer. So here we need to identify again in room rentals, like what is the exact parameter based on which the room rental revenue is based on. So since we are investigating the mismatch, the room rental revenue can be broken into number of tourists at our hotels into spend per tourist. Spend per tourist basically means how much amount they are spending. So then here, if you see, the interviewer has themselves given the data that the number of tourists at a hotel has gone by 6%, but spend per tourist has gone down by 2%. To make the interview tougher, the interviewer can just remain silent until the candidate asks that question. So from getting this hint that the spend per tourist has gone by 6%, so it's a small decline in spend per tourist, which has taken down the revenue growth from 6% to 4%. Then there are alternate ways to like find out what are the parameters affecting. Total number of rooms available per night into percentage average occupancy into room rate per night into 365. So like it just, it depends on the way you are analyzing. The real world problems, obviously you need to consider 100% constraints and you need to give like answers, like very accurate answers. But when it comes to case study, based on the time you have, then based on the complexity of case, you need to decide that how like the approach, can it get complicated or are there any simple alternatives? If you see this formula, like percentage average occupancy, in the first one it is assumed 100. That's why it is just total number of tourists. Okay, sorry, there is a different way of looking. Here we are just seeing the number of tourists who are there in hotel and the money which they are spending. But here we are seeing total number of rooms available into number of rooms which are occupied into room rate per night into 365. So we can again analyze that is the percentage average occupancy, is it decreasing or not? Then has the room rate per night, has it increased or decreased? So such kind of analysis can be done. And one more important thing here is, and in any case study, like by now you might have understood that how complicated it can actually get, and like a 3-4 problem statement, it can be like 3 or 4 pages of detailed calculation. So in middle of this calculation, you should never forget that what is your end goal. Because if you see the problem statement, this is our main concern, that why there is mismatch between the 6% tourist growth rate and 4% revenue growth rate. So like, I mean, you should not forget that what was your goal, and you are just now trying to investigate deep into one particular branch and fail to realize that you are not reaching towards your end target. Then in this breakdown, we would be told by interviewer that percentage occupancy has gone up by 4%, room rate and number of available rooms remaining the same. The next step would be to understand the mismatch between percentage occupancy growth of 4% and tourist growth rate of 6%, and hence we haven't moved any closer to the problem isolation. That is why every step in the case must be goal oriented. So I'll just repeat this part again, try to observe it carefully. Assuming we would have gone with this approach, that the total rental revenue is room available into percentage occupancy into room rate, and if we get further data based on which we try to make some analysis, but again it is not in at par with our initial goal, then there is no use of asking those questions. That's why I always repeat it again and again, that you should ask the relevant questions. Then let's investigate the spend per tourist. So again, like these formulas you will get by experience only. Like these are quite simple formulas, but later if you need to analyze one particular parameter and make up a formula, the general advice which I can give you is, firstly, decide that what parameters would be needed, and then you do various combination, that is your addition, subtraction, multiplication, division of those parameters to identify like the dependence of those parameters to the actual metric which you are evaluating. So the spend per tourist, it can be based on the average length of stay per customer into rate per customer per night. Then again, it is told that rate per customer per night has remained same, average length of the stay has decreased. So again, we got the further data that this average length of the stay has decreased. So we know, okay, now rate has got nothing to do with it. We need to focus on the average length. And again, here the interviewer is making it look easy. Like in the general, if the interviewer wants, this line could not have been told. It is our duty to ask that, has the average length increased or decreased, and the rate per person per night, has it increased or decreased? So the candidate says, that's very interesting. We know the industry is showing a revenue growth rate of 4%. Do we know if the average length of the stay of customers has decreased? We don't need specific data of competitors, but there might be a body like a tourism body which keeps industry data. Then notice the candidate is asking for information which is obtainable. So like, you can just ignore this part. Yes, we can check that. And in fact, there's an industry-wide trend that average length of stay has decreased. So again, like there's a reassurance that this is a industry-wide trend and not specific to your hotel. So now this is the importance of segmentation. And one more thing, I would just take a small break and would like to tell that why I was like stressing that you should not follow a particular framework and come up with more like a checklist. Because if you notice that the questions were not asked in a framework kind of manner, based on what the candidate is understanding, he or she is asking more and more questions to get the data. So it is not like, okay, now first I'm finishing the company, then the product and customers, competitors. No, it is based on as much like how, what are questions you need in order to get your answer. That should be enough. So like in the later case, once you gain experience, try to avoid using frameworks and come like try to understand the problem naturally. So this is the like main objective I was telling, right? Your presentation skills should be important. So far, whatever analysis we did here, this is the summarized form, that the revenue growth rate is 4%. Then it can be, the revenue can be divided into room rentals and value added services. In room rentals, again, like the there is 4% growth, then the room rentals can be divided into like the factors which are based on the customers and the spend per customers. So this is in line with the with the growth rate, 36%. Then the spend per customer has declined. Then again, this will be dependent upon length of the stay and rate per customer per night. So like based on how complex it can get, there'll be so many sub branches. And as we keep on doing our segmentation, there will be one block which will be the root cause of the entire problem. So like I'll just go off topic a little bit, that such kind of projects, that even a small change, like it can cost crores of rupees or dollars to the company. So that's why all these management firms, they are paid a lot, because like these will be very small issues which we may or may not be analyzing, and we'll be like spending lots of money in something else which is not the actual cause for our problem. So yeah, let's get back. We have exhausted the use of profitability framework. By exhausted, it is mean that profitability framework, we have like adopted how it is used, and we are trying to use it in this case. It allows us to identify where the problem is. We then move to customized framework to find out why there is a problem. Because of the effective use of the profitability framework, we are now asking the more specific question, why has the length of stay reduced? This also helps our next line of questioning be very specific. So, okay, the candidate says, I'd like to move by understanding two areas of business. Then now they are asking various questions, that customers, what has changed in the behavior that makes the average length of stay shorter? Then product, anything that has changed in the industry's offering that forces customer to shorten duration of stay. Then competition, we can deprioritize this branch since everyone is facing the problem. So it was already made clear many times that this was an industry-wide problem and not a problem with respect to the company. That's why this branch has been removed. Now for the customer and product, these are like the initial questions. Now again, based on what data the interviewer is giving, we will further ask more questions. Then the interviewer says, all right, why don't we analyze the customer branch first? So here the candidate wants to know the customer segmentation. Then segmentation based on what? Here he wants to ask that what are the types of customers. According to him, the various types are business and tourist customers, families or singles, then the geography or customers. And again, let me tell you one thing, that this is something which we have to come up with. This is like, now this type of segmentation, it is we who have decided. So you should, that's why I told that you should have the industrial knowledge. So in tourism industry, you should have this general knowledge that what are the various types of customers, so that if you are solving a case study with respect to that industry, you will know what type of question should be asked. Then this is a segmentation which the candidate has suggested. What about type of customers or tourists? I would believe tourists tend to stay longer than the business travelers who come in only for a few days. Then the interviewer again, they have made it easier by saying that you can assume all are tourists. So just imagine that if they would have said that 40% is business and 60% is tourist, then again in tourist 40% is family and 60% are singles. So it can get more and more complicated. So the assumption is that all are tourists, then family or singles. I would assume because the family has more members, because of they has many more members, and because of the collective constraints like working parents, school for kids, they would stay shorter than singles who could be lone rangers. So the interviewer, now he is giving one more data, that for every single customer, we have 9 customers who are part of a family. Then has there been a change in split? Are both segments showing a reduction in length of stay? So again, you need to identify these ratios, because now at this point of time, like you're nowhere for, like if you just look at this statement, for every single customer, we have 9 customers who are part of the family. So at this particular point, we cannot analyze that why is the tourist growth rate and the revenue growth rate is changing. So we need to analyze further now. Has there been a change in the split? Are both segments showing a reduction in length of stay? So the ratio is 1:9. Has there been the change in the ratio? And the length of stay, has it reduced for both the singles and family, or is it only for a particular part? Both segments have grown at the same rate. They have also seen the same reduction in length of the stay. Notice, over and above asking for segmentation, the candidate is also asking what has changed within the segments. Now, this what question will help you analyze, what are the exact reasons, and it will also help you to eliminate the branches which have remained the same. Just information of what the current split is does not tell anything. It is the change in the split that matters. Then, what about geography of where the customers come from? So, here now we are trying to get more specific. As of now, we have established that all the tourists, all the customers are tourists. Now, and we know the split of single and the family members. But now we need to analyze what is the geography of the customers. So again, now this segmentation, it was like, it is purely with respect to this case study. Now, like based on the problem, maybe you may even ask segmentation on the based of age. But do younger people come here, or is it the older people? So like that, you can also do based on the income segregation, lower class, middle class, and upper middle class. I guess in the guesstimate session, it would have been already covered. But just to say that there are so many segmentations available. So what about geography of where customers come from? We have customers coming from North America, Europe, and then from Asia. So do we have split between North America, Europe, and Asia? And has there been a reduction in length of stay of each segment? Has there been a change in split? Just try to, like, I'll just take a 5 seconds or 10 seconds break. See what kind of questions they are asking. Okay, so we have established that these are our customers. Then remember that our objective was to find the length of stay. So has there been a reduction in length of stay of each segment? And has there been change in the split of the customers? Then North America, Europe makes about 50% of the customers, and Asia is the rest. There has been no reduction in length of stay of each segment. However, the number of Asian customers has been increasing in the past 2 to 3 years. So just read this statement again, because this is the point after which some doors are opening and you are coming to a conclusion. North America and Europe makes about 50% of the customers, and Asia is the rest. There has been no reduction in length of stay of each segment. However, the number of Asian customers has been increasing in the past 2 to 3 years. So that's interesting. What is the length of stay of each segment? Then Asian tourists typically have a shorter stay than North American and Europe tourists. Then the candidate says, this is basically of their generally lower affordability, leading them to having smaller vacations. Now, this is a generalization kind of here that they are assuming that Asians have lower affordability. It may or may not be true. There can be other reasons as well. Suppose it can be that since Thailand is a part of Asia, so it is more of a local tourist attraction rather than it's too far away. So they may just go for shorter stay and come back. So now suppose if the interviewer would have said no, then again we need to analyze that, okay, what's the reason why Asian tourists have a shorter stay when compared to the North American European? That's why, like I emphasize, that just don't read case studies. You need to do practice sessions with your friends so that you'll analyze that what are the types of questions and what real problems you'll face. If you just read this case study, it will look okay, it is just a step-by-step procedure, and okay, even I may do if it is asked, but the real reality won't be that. You'll surely get stuck up in between without a proper practice. So there is the, because of general lower affordability leading them to having smaller vacation. Yes, that settles it then. Though we are having 6% growth rate in overall number of tourists, the growth rate of Asian customers who stay for shorter duration is more than Western tourists staying longer. This is the leading to revenue growth rate of only 4%. So although the customers are increasing, the Asian customers are increasing more and they stay for shorter time. So that was the whole, that was the reason because of which there was this mismatch of 6% and 4%. So now I guess you might have realized that how important all this segmentation was, because even if you would have missed few questions in between, you wouldn't have arrived at this answer. So yeah, that's the like main end objective of the case interview. But wait, there is 20% revenue coming from VAS as well. Can we say VAS, which comprises of Wi-Fi services, laundry, use of banquet halls, is also related to length of stay of customer and hence seen a 4% growth rate. Now, one thing I would like to tell that like these are very detailed calculations. So like, although, I mean, you have to do those calculations, but you should never forget your, like already I told this before, you should never forget your end goal. And you should always remember your exact step-by-step approach, because then only you will know that is there anything which we are missing or not. If you notice that we were doing so much segmentation of only this part, but we didn't consider VAS at all. So now the candidate asks that shall we, for VAS also there is only 4% growth because the length of the stay has remained shorter, and hence because the more you stay, the more you'll use the services. That's why like this particular part, length of stay, is related with this. So that's why you should know how to ask the right questions. So yeah, this ends the mock case interview. So for further reading, like you will find literally so many resources on YouTube or Google, or you can ask from your seniors. But for a beginner or an intermediate person, you can, these three would be more than enough. The first one is Victor Chang Case Interview Workshop. Anyone who is in the world of consulting will surely know about what this is. It is basically a 12 video series workshop where proper business frameworks and few sample case studies have been discussed, and it is quite informative. Then the next one is Case in Point. It is a foreign author book, and there are like, it gives a proper introduction to the world of consulting, and it has so many elaborate examples, frameworks, and various tips and tricks to crack case studies. Then the third one, and my personal favorite, it is Case Interview Cracked. So this is a book written by two IITians. You can just Google this name and you can get the soft copy of it. So this has basically, after all the explanation and approaches to solve case studies, it has 32 case interviews. The case interview involves guesstimates as well. So you and your friends, you can just one versus one, you can practice all these case studies, and it will help you in your further interviews. So guys, any further questions which you have, you can always contact me at this number. This is my WhatsApp as well as you can call me at this number. Then for detailed information about our further events, you can visit our Facebook page, our website, our LinkedIn page, and our YouTube channel. And please follow all these pages and share it among your friends. And one more thing I would like to say that when I was telling about the prerequisites, just 1 minute. Yeah, I was talking about the prerequisites. So we BDAC has already conducted data visualization by through Tableau and data analysis by Excel. The links for these sessions have already been are present in our YouTube channel. So the interested participants may go and watch them. Then I guess that is end of my presentation. So thank you. Now we can go for the doubt session. Any doubts? You can just
start. Ayan.
Yes, sir.
Ayan, this is Sharma. That was a wonderful session, Ayan.
Yes, thank you.
Hello?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. But as I said, I would like to add one small point to this entire session.
Yes, sir.
Hello? Yeah, like when we are talking about strategies and all, there is one more strategy called Ansoff matrix. Have you ever any time heard about it? Ansoff matrix?
No, sir.
Yeah, it is something like, for example, if someone is saying my product is not doing good in the existing market, we usually think about changing the product, no? How to bring the changes about in the product, right?
Yes, sir.
So that is not only necessary. We can go for with the old product, you can go for a new market in this type of situation sometimes. You can go for old product and new market, or new product, old market. And also new product in new market. These are the various permutations and combinations we have. Like in this case, what we can do, product may not be actually changed, but I may go for a new market. The same product which I am giving in the existing market, I may change the market to these customers to another customers.
Yes.
You got my point?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So, yeah, I suggest you to just go, because this entire presentation, I suggest all the friends to please go through that ANSOF matrix, ANSOFF, ANSOF matrix. That is also related to strategy. This, from my side, I want to add this point to all of you. That's all. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
So, guys, any doubts, any other doubts which you have, please feel free to ask. You can even ask in the chat box. And guys, is there any specific part which you feel like